My name is Saitoh. I'm a director of Arctic Research Center. It is most interesting for me. Marine ecosystem is changing in the Arctic Ocean. Today, I would like to introduce the method that I developed to explore changing of marine ecosystem. I brought some phytoplankton I study. Can you see what's inside? If you enlarge them, looks like this. Aren't they beautiful? Both of them are very tiny phytoplankton from the Arctic Ocean, measuring 0.002 millimeter and 0.14 millimeter, respectively. To distinguish between them, I call this one a small phytoplankton and that one a large phytoplankton. Actually, there are a difference in size as common crawfish and killer whales. Except these two kinds of phytoplankton, there are various species of phytoplankton, ranging in size from small to large. Phytoplankton species control predators, zooplankton species, and more relatively large fish species. Phytoplankton is key species to determine the bottom-up system of marine ecosystem in each region. I have looking at the distribution of these small and large phytoplankton across the entire Earth from space. It allows us to see what's happening all around the world. This image of phytoplankton distribution taken by satellite, referred to as the Nimbus 7 in 1978. The green part indicates the area with the abundance of phytoplankton, and the amount of phytoplankton decreases as the green color changes to blue. When I saw this map, I want to identify the distribution of small and large phytoplankton. In order to solve that, it is necessary to sample the optical property of phytoplankton in the ocean. For that, I get on the board Oceanography, a training ship belonging to Hokkaido University, and I really sailed to the Arctic Ocean. To determine standard value, I examine the absorption and scattering spectra of phytoplankton in the Arctic Ocean. Sunlight shines over the sea and phytoplankton in the sea. So chlorophyll pigment in phytoplankton absorbed in specific wavelengths, and the rest is scattered. The water-living light is then received by visible sensor on the satellite. In this way, we can see global distribution of phytoplankton. As a result, small phytoplankton indicate spectra like these, and large phytoplankton indicate spectra like these. In both absorption and scattering spectra, there was a significant difference between seawater with small phytoplankton and that with large phytoplankton at around 488 nanometer. And there was almost no difference between them at around 555 nanometer. I succeeded in making a model to estimate the ratio between small and large phytoplankton using ratio of absorption and the slope of scattering. To apply this model to the satellite data, I came up to understand difference in distribution of small and large phytoplankton. This is the result with the other method from global phytoplankton size distribution. Small phytoplankton is distributed over the sea of the world equally. Large phytoplankton is distribution in area along the coastal region and understood that distribution was partially very high. Then I focus to the Arctic region. In the Chukchi Sea, recently, the period of sea ice cover tend to be shortened. I understood the ratio of large phytoplankton decreased with age. Surprisingly, in contrast, the period covered by sea ice in the Bering Sea became longer and ratio of large phytoplankton increased. In other words, ratio between small phytoplankton and large phytoplankton makes it fall down reversibly and until now. Okay, let me move to the next. How the marine ecosystem changed through the such phenomena? Where do you think the dominant large phytoplankton in the Arctic Ocean? They're actually here at the bottom of sea ice. Large phytoplankton called ice algae exist with sea ice. In the sea, where ice algae is dominant, krill and other large zooplankton eat ice algae. And then, whales and other living organisms eat the large zooplankton. In addition, sea ice provide habitat for polar bears that need sea ice for hunting seals. In the Arctic Ocean, the presence of sea ice helps maintain a very precious, rich ecosystem that can sustain large marine and terrestrial mammals at the top of the ecosystem. However, there is a concern that global warming may drastically change the marine ecosystem in the Arctic Ocean. Two phenomena that occur simultaneously due to global warming can be cited as a reason for this. The first phenomenon is a decrease in the sea ice. This caused the ratio of small phytoplankton to increase to more than that of ice algae, which are large phytoplankton that exist together with sea ice, thereby changing the food chain. The other is an increase in sea temperature. This causes a distribution range of living organisms unable to live in the cold Arctic Ocean to shift to the north. However, living organisms that originally lived in Arctic Ocean cannot go any further north. In short, they will have nowhere left to live on this planet. Let's look at the prediction of distribution change. Current distribution range of Cham salmon is from Japan and the North Pacific Ocean to Oregon in the US, British Columbia in Canada, and the Bering Sea. However, this range is expected to shift north to entire Chukchi Sea, especially the area along the coast of Alaska by 2095. From the perspective of fisheries resources, this change may be advantageous for Alaska. But this would mean declining catch in Japan and Canada. Changing Arctic marine ecosystem have a potential to cause a problem that would significantly affect marine resources in multiple countries. Marine resources are closely connected to problems involving food and the economy. Wow, this is my favorite cuisine, or sushi. This one, salmon is on top. We must manage resources in the Arctic Ocean so that our children and grandchildren can also enjoy fresh fish. We use data from field survey in the Arctic Ocean and satellite in space to examine change in the ecosystem stemming from global warming, thus contributing to sustainable resource management. I hope students around the world will study this hot subject on the Arctic Ocean together with us. Now then, if you will excuse me, it's time to eat. Thank you.